Hey there, out late but greats. It's like out late and great. I like that. If you're watching this, you're great. Out late and great. I love it. I'm Samantha, and I have not been around YouTube for a while, but Mick asked me to chime in here for this week's question on OLBG, and I just couldn't resist, so the topic this week is about, I'm going to try to remember it. It's a question: do you think bisexuals and trans people are underrepresented or discriminated against in the community? I think that there are so many directions I could take this question, my response to it at least. Just the cloud of things on my mind are, what does it mean to be underrepresented? And what part of the community are we talking about? So I'm thinking about community because I'm still trying to figure it out, right? So I get that community is like a collection of people with common interest or common characteristics, in this case, sexuality and gender being different than the heteronormative standards of the world that we live in. But the community's so big that I think it's actually really hard to be able to talk about the community as a whole, even if we were talking about the LGBT community. Are we talking about the North American LGBT community? And what about the European LGBT community? And if we talk about the global LGBT community, there's just so much to consider. You know, in this country, it's safe to be out in many, many places. There are some countries where it's not safe to be gay. You could be killed. And I think about how that affects the community. So I guess for all intents and purposes, let's talk about community, in this case being the YouTube community. Or let's say the internet community. The internet community of LGBT folks. 'Cause, you know, there are plenty of folks that don't get online and don't participate on YouTube or message boards or Reddit or Facebook or Twitter or any of these other social networks. So let's just talk about the people that do. I'd like to believe, although I have no data, that everyone is represented. I don't know about who's represented more than who. I'm inclined to say that the people that are the most vocal are the ones that are the most represented. And I don't really know who that is. I see people talking about being gay or lesbian or bisexual or transgender or trans star in lots of different places on the internet. I think that some of these communities, smaller, you know, let's take the bisexual community. I don't know if the bisexual community is larger than the lesbian community, for example. I think if you're a person that is bisexual and you are looking to connect with people in the bisexual community on the internet, that you're going to seek that out and you're going to be more of a participant in that pocket of the community than, say, the gay community or the trans community. And that's okay. That's okay. I think the important thing is that everybody can find a place that they feel comfortable with. Just like we all go through this journey of trying to be comfortable with who we are. And I know that for me, that it's taken a lot of work to do that. It's a very human experience. If I may go on a tangent, just to become comfortable with who you are. That's like a human experience that goes beyond sexual orientation or gender identity. That's a human thing. I think everybody struggles to accept who they are, especially when we are, at least in this country, and many countries, bombarded with imagery about who and what we are supposed to be or supposed to want to be. I think that for each of us, accepting who we are and loving who we are and knowing who we are, it's incredibly important, and it doesn't come easily. It comes with a lot of work, and not everybody is up for that. I'm going off on several tangents. Just like we all struggle to find and be comfortable with who we are, we also struggle to find community of like people. So I guess when I think about underrepresentation for the LGBT community, I think about, well, are people from these different pockets going and being vocal and being visible in pockets that are directed toward others in the broader community? So, I don't know. I think that, what do I think? Let me think about what I think. I have to make a decision about how I feel about this whole thought process. I think that the most important thing is that people can find a place where they're comfortable, people that they want to be connected to, and, have a voice that is heard and recognized. And I think that if each of us as an individual has that, then the broader community is going to become stronger, because those of us that are able to find ways to be comfortable with who we are and discover that there are people like us, that gives us power in a way. And we carry that power with us into our daily lives. And we share that power, or we make that power visible to people that aren't in the LGBT community for one reason or another. And I think that that power can be influential and informative to people who aren't sort of deep in the community, learning about it on their own volition. Is that the right word? I don't know, I need a dictionary. All right, everyone. I'm going to call it here. I want to thank everybody for having me as a guest this week on Out Late and Great. And I hope you all have a wonderful March, and looking forward to Easter and any other holidays you may celebrate. I'm excited about the sun being out more here in Seattle, although it's nighttime now. I have my light on. Anyway, take care. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you again.